بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والآقبة للمتقين والجنة للموحدين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. One of the latest publications that we have outside is a book called The Clarification of Noble Character, and it's a beautiful read and an important one for our families. And I'm also asked to announce here that we're having a book launch next week, and there are tickets for sale for this book launch. I'll give you the details of it very quickly. The 26th of September at the Islamia Auditorium, we hope to have a live link up with the author and a few other people. There'll be a few presentations. It takes place from opposite to, let's say, 3 o'clock, from 3 o'clock till before Maghrib. So what you could basically do is you come to the Islamia Auditorium and you have a time dedicated in an environment where we will be speaking about a day in the life of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The book that we are launching is a book called Prophetic Guidance and was authored by Sheikh Umar Al-Khatib, who is a senior lecturer at the Darul Mustafa Institute in Tarim, Hadramaut. The Khatib family is an Ansar family, by the way. So his lineage goes up to some of the Ansar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them. The book in itself, Prophetic Guidance, if I were to be honest with you, my first appreciation of the book was that you're recreating the wheel. Books like this already exist. But when I actually took the time out, and surprisingly, you know, this was exactly the same sentiments of Sheikh Faraz Rabbani, but when I actually took the time out to page through the book, and that was last week, Wednesday, you know, just before our Burda gathering, I found it to be extremely beneficial, and I found it to be something that every Muslim household must have, and it's something that our children should be taught within our homes and within the madrasas. And these are my thoughts of this book, and that is that we know certain du'as, and those du'as are engraved within our lives, and it's very easy for us to practice on those du'as subconsciously. I go to the toilet and without thinking, I recite, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ithi. And when I come out of the toilet, subconsciously I recite, Khufranaka alhamdulillahi alladhi adhaba anni al-adha wa afa. When I go to bed, subconsciously, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, and eventually, Allahumma bismika amutu ahya. So these are actions and du'as that our teachers and our parents instilled within our lives, and we are thankful and grateful for that. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's sunnah did not stop there. It was more comprehensive. It covered every turn in your life. And if this book covers to detail from the time you wake up till you go back to bed in the evening, what you should do, how you should do it. And it's all prophetic adhkar. He doesn't mention anything in here that doesn't come from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which makes it beautiful. So, by way of example, I'll show you why you need this book. Who knows the dua you recite when you leave home in the morning? For work or otherwise? Hey? I hear some voices from the sisters. So one of the du'as Rasulullah taught us, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an adilla aw udal aw azilla aw uzal ila akhiri. What does the du'a recite when I come to the masjid? The Prophet taught us a specific du'a to recite when leaving home for the masjid. Allahumma inni as'aluka fi haqqi sa'ilina alayk. If you don't know those two du'as, you need to get a copy of this book. So that you can learn it. So that it can become part of your practice and the practice of your daughters and the practice of your sons and the practice of your spouses. Why? So that in a year from now, I can also do that subconsciously. Without thinking, the idea will just flow from my mouth. But we need to make a start. And in doing that, we'll be imbibing with us the way, the sunnah of Sayyiduna wa Mawlana Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barak wa sallam. Please do try to recite the Subhanallah wa alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa allahu akbar wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi illa al-azim as much as you possibly can during the month of Dhul Hijjah. And if you are able to join our Tahajjud program, please try to do so, 4:10 to 5:10. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.